Hey guys, welcome to Exit Tutorial channel again. And today in this chapter, we will learn how to count characters in R, cells or range of cells in Excel. So we have previously covered how to count a specific word in range of cells or in a cell. And similarly, we will count the number of characters in particular cell. So this is gonna be very interesting video here. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please do it, because in upcoming days, months and year, we will cover each and everything about Excel and full-fledged course for free. So let's get started. So here we have the demo data. Obviously this is the demo data for the learning purposes, but if you have the series of ranges here where you want to crack count a specific character in your cells or range of cells, then you can do it easily with these formulas we're gonna cover in this video. But starting from the basics, how to count a number of characters in a cell. So it's very easy. You just need to put len formula here, right? And you need to select the range cell, obviously particular cell here, and you will get this. But if you want to find the range of length of the range of this here, then you can select here. You can get the number of count in respect to that particular cell. Here we got the 8 number of characters here, similarly tutorials here and here. But if you want to count the, you know, do you add it up here, because it will displays as a series of number. But if you want to count the sum of these following lengths, then you can just add the sum in front of len function and just click enter. You will get the 41, but you won't get the 41 right away if you have the older version of Microsoft Excel, because after the 2018, Microsoft updated this functionality for the later part of or you can say later version of the Excel, maybe because of the Microsoft 365 subscription. But if you don't have this type of Excel versions, then you can do it simply. Just type like this formula, and you need to input the array function in this. Array is not a standalone function, this is just the helper function. If you want to calculate the series of number, then the array formula is perfect for you, and it gives you the idea, or you can say it gives you the ease to calculate big data in a simpler format. Otherwise you have to calculate len a2 plus len a3 plus len a4 like that to get the sum of all the lengths in the particular range. So in this way, you can just input the select here if you have got the older version only. If you have the newer version, if this sum work for you, then you are fine, because after that Microsoft have added that functionality for the dynamic array functionality. So what you need to do is, if you have the older version, then you can just enter control plus shift plus enter here. You get the curly here. Yes, you will get the curly brackets here. You don't need to enter it manually, because it won't work like that. You need to enter the keyboard shortcut. What was that? Control plus shift plus enter, and control plus shift plus return for the Mac OS users. So that's how you can do it easily. So this is the example here, how you can calculate the number of characters in particular cell or in range of cells. So next we will do a little bit. So next we will do some advanced functions here, advanced example. So advanced example is not that much advanced, but we will count the number of A in that particular cell, right? This is very easy, you can say it's a one, but if you want to calculate the whole in range of cells, then it will be difficult for you. To do that, we just need to do len a2. We will select that particular range here. What the idea of finding A from that particular cell, you can do that easily with the Power Query, but here we're gonna learn the functions here, which will become very handy if you go to into your daily use of Excel, then it comes very handy. So what you're gonna do is len a2, it will give the length of hole here, which is the 7, and you need to subtract everything except character A, which we're gonna find it. So how to do that? We will use the len and substitute function. Len and substitute function we have also used in the previous video, where we have extracted the word John. So likewise, some users also asked me how to count a specific character. So this is the video for you. And then len. Now here we will use the substitute function, because we want to substitute A with the blank value. Here we got the text here. We will add the old text with the in quoted format A here, and the new text will be nothing, will be blank. Don't put the space in between because it will add the one character more, which is the space itself. So here we close it down the parentheses of substitute and the length, and then we find here, yes, we found the number of character A in that particular cell is 1. Similarly, we can do that with the whole range. How to do that? We just delete the A here and put the ranges here. Similarly, in the substitute also, we can put the range here. Here you got the closed it, and it will give you the series of cells here where you can find the number of that particular A characters in that cell. But to count, sum it up, what we need to do is sum, open the parentheses and close it down here. Now if you have the older version, you need to press what? Yes, Control plus Shift plus Enter. But I don't need to do because this is the Microsoft 365 version. So here we got the 3 times I got the A here. If you want to find out the number E, let's find out how many are there. So we got the name E here, 2, 3, and 4. What? We got the 4 here, but why does it give only 3 here? Because it didn't add up the uppercase of Excel E. To add those values, the upper and also the lower cases of that particular character, you need to add one more function. Yes, it goes on and on, but yes, you need to add one more function. I know it gets tedious, but it gets fun when you practice more and more function daily on the daily basis. So here we get, after the substitute, we need to add the lower function here. Okay, so we need to close it down here. So here we close it down here, and we got the 4. So with the help of lower function, what we need to do is, what we got is the number E, which was the upper case here in the Excel. So we have added those also in this particular counting with the help of lower function in this particular formula. So hope you got the idea how to count the specific character in Excel. So if you have got it, please click the like button. Don't be greedy. If you have learned something, then please click the like button. And if you want to see such videos in the future, then you can also subscribe us, or you can share to whomever you want if they need to know how to count characters in Excel using these various functions. Hope we got to see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.